Hi, this is Andre. There's a very specific and unusual looping technique that Henry Kaiser first started doing in the 1970s and has continued to use throughout his career up to and including today. There are two specific components to it. The first is zero feedback, which means that anything you play into the looper will only repeat one time. The second aspect is modulating the clock rate of the loop, which produces a vari-speed effect. That means that as the pitch gets higher, things speed up, and as the pitch drops, things slow down. Henry's technique involves modulating the clock of the loop with a square wave LFO. In practical terms, that means that you get immediate jumps to musical intervals both above and below the original pitch. The combination of zero feedback and pitch modulation gives a really unique sound, where nothing ever repeats exactly the way it was originally played. There's a great video where Henry walks through this technique. It's hosted by Guitar Player Magazine, and I'll link to it in the description below. I've been interested in trying this technique out for myself, and in this video I'm using the Chase Bliss Blooper in conjunction with the Empress Zoia. The Blooper is the main looping engine here. The repeats knob is a feedback control, and turning it all the way down gives you zero feedback. The Blooper also has a modifier called Stepped Speed, which changes the pitch and speed of the loop in octaves and fifths. By modulating the Stepped Speed modifier with an LFO, the Blooper can create a sound very similar to Henry's technique. I'm using the Zoia here as an LFO generator to modulate the pitch of the loop by sending MIDI CC commands to the stepped speed modifier. Now, the Blooper does have an onboard LFO system called ramping, which I like a lot, but for this particular technique, I wasn't really able to get the effect I was looking for using ramping alone, which is why I configured a separate LFO setup on the Zoia. This particular combination doesn't offer every possible bit of functionality that Henry's own setups would, but it does make the basic technique available to explore. As always, thank you very much for tuning in.
Thank you.